गुड मॉर्निंग सर। सर
So let us talk about whatever we have discussed till now. We talked about conservation of mass, momentum, Navier-Stokes equations. We saw that there are four equations of motion in three dimensions. So for a 3D system, we have a continuity equation. In vector form, it can be written as del dot u equal to 0. Or in scalar form, it can be written as dou u by dou x, dou v by dou y, dou w by dou z equal to 0. And there are three momentum equations. In vector form again, they can be written as rho, sorry, this is in vector form, so it should be minus grad p. Plus del dot tau, where tau is the stress tensor. And then plus some other forces. They can be gravitational force, magnetic force, electric force, or any other kind of force acting on the fluid. So if it is a gravitational force, we can write it as rho g. Okay. So how many equations are these? These are total four equations. One continuity and three momentum equations. So these are known as Navier-Stokes equations. So I hope till this point it was clear. In the last few lectures that I uploaded on the YouTube channel, there was a derivation of continuity and momentum equations. I hope you have watched those lectures. How many of you have watched the lectures? Please raise your hands. Okay, no problem. So these are four equations, and we saw that there are four unknowns also. This is from the last live lecture. Pressure is an unknown, and three components of velocity, u vector, this is unknown. So total four unknowns. Four equations, four unknowns. We can find out these four unknowns. Okay. Now let us try to solve these equations for some sample problems. Let us take the problem that we started the discussion of viscosity with. There is a flat surface and there is a fluid on top of the surface, and there is another plate which is being pulled with some velocity, some constant velocity, capital U. And the bottom plate is fixed, so the velocity there is zero. And remember that the convention that we are using here, velocity vector is written as u I cap plus v j cap. This is y direction, this is x direction. When we write a vector sign above u, we mean velocity vector. And if we don't write any vector sign above u, that is a scalar. Okay, and that is the velocity magnitude in the x direction. And v is the velocity magnitude in the y direction. Now, let us write the continuity equation for this. This is in two dimensions. So there are only two velocity components, u and v. Now let us also write the momentum equation here. Two momentum equations actually in x and y directions. This one I am writing for x direction. Okay, how many of you understand these equations? How we got these equations? From this momentum equation. Okay, so please go through those lectures. For now, I'll just explain it very briefly. This dou p by dou x is the easiest term to understand. We had minus del p there in vector form, so it can be written as minus dou p by dou x I cap. Dou p by dou y j cap. And we collect all the I cap terms in the x momentum equation. So we get minus dou p by dou x there. Now the left hand side, which is written as rho dou u by dou t u dot del u. What this means is, first of all, this term dou u by dou t is actually dou u by dou t I cap plus dou v by dou t j cap. Velocity is a vector, so that can be expanded as u I cap plus v j cap. And operating dou by dou t over these two terms, we get this. So all the I cap terms we are collecting for x momentum equation. Therefore, you get dou u by dou t on the left hand side here. Now this term, in the last live lecture, we saw what is a divergence and what is a gradient. Del dot u, you have seen, but what is del u? डेल डॉट यू इज डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ वेलोसिटी विच इज अ स्केलर, बट वॉट इज डेल यू? दैट इज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी दैट वी हैव सीन व्हेन वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्ट्रेस टेंसर विच वॉज रिटन एज म्यू डेल यू प्लस डेल यू ट्रांसपोज. सो वी सेड दैट वी कैन डिराइव द फॉर्मूला और वी कैन डिराइव दिस एक्सप्रेशन फॉर डेल यू विच इज एक्चुअली अ टेंसर बिकॉज ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड यू हैव अ टेंसर सो बोथ ऑफ दीज टर्म्स शुड बी टेंसर. सो हाउ डू यू डिराइव द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर डेल यू? यू डू अ मेट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन डो बाई डो एक्स डो बाई डो वाई टाइम्स यू एंड वी. सो फ्रॉम दिस यू गेट अ 2/2 टेंसर. ओके एंड देन यू डू अ डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ वेलोसिटी वेक्टर विद दिस टेंसर दैट इज यू डॉट डेल यू. व्हेन यू डॉट अ वेक्टर विद अ टेंसर फाइनली यू गेट अ वेक्टर. सो हियर यू विल गेट अ वेक्टर विद आई कैप एंड जे कैप टर्म्स. व्हेन यू कलेक्ट ऑल द आई कैप टर्म्स यू गेट द एक्स मोमेंटम इक्वेशन. ओके वन मोर वे टू सी दिस द इजियर वे विच डज नॉट इन्वॉल्व टेंसर्स इज टू फर्स्ट डू द डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ यू एंड डेल. सो कंबाइनिंग यू एंड डेल फर्स्ट व्हाट डू यू गेट फ्रॉम देयर? लेट अस राइट इट. यू आई कैप प्लस वी जे कैप डॉट प्रोडक्ट विद आई कैप जे कैप. व्हेन यू डू द डॉट प्रोडक्ट यू गेट अ न्यू ऑपरेटर विच इज यू डो बाई डो एक्स प्लस वी डो बाई डो वाई. दिस इज एन ऑपरेटर विच विल एक्ट ऑन समथिंग. इन दिस केस इट इज एक्टिंग ऑन यू वेक्टर यू. सो कलेक्टिंग ऑल द आई कैप एंड जे कैप टर्म सेपरेटली आई कैप टर्म विल बी यू डो यू बाई डो एक्स दिस वन हियर प्लस वी डो बाई डो वाई ऑफ यू. सिमिलरली द जे कैप टर्म विल हैव वी द वर्टिकल वाई वेलोसिटी सो प्लस जे कैप यू डो बाई डो एक्स वी प्लस वी डो बाई डो वाई वी. सो हियर यू कैन सी द टर्म दैट वी हैव रिटन इन द ब्रैकेट्स. वी रोट यू डो बाई यू डो यू बाई डो एक्स प्लस वी डो यू बाई डो वाई. ओके आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. जस्ट द मैथ्स पार्ट ऑफ इट द डेरिवेशन यू कैन सी इन द लास्ट लेक्चर और द लास्ट लास्ट लेक्चर. इज देर एनी क्वेश्चन? एंड द राइट हैंड साइड हाउ वी गेट म्यू डो टू यू बाई डो एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस डो टू यू बाई डो वाई स्क्वायर. अगेन वॉट यू गेट हियर इज म्यू डो टू बाई डो एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस डो टू बाई डो वाई स्क्वायर विच एक्ट्स ऑन यू आई कैप प्लस वी जे कैप. देन कलेक्टिंग ऑल द आई टर्म्स फॉर द एक्स मोमेंटम इक्वेशन you get dou to u by dou x square plus dou to u by dou y square. Similarly, in the y momentum equation, you will have dou 2 v by dou x square plus dou 2 v by dou y square. Now let me similarly write the y momentum equation. So we have these three equations to work with: continuity, this is the continuity equation, then x momentum equation and y momentum equation. The unknowns are pressure and the two velocity components u and v. So in principle we can solve these. Now we can simplify these equations, because I don't know if you can solve these equations. Actually, there is a millennium problem by Clay Mathematics Institute. They say that even if you can prove that there exists a smooth solution for Navier-Stokes equations, just the existence of solution, then you get $1 million. Okay, no one has been able to do that till now, let alone solving the Navier-Stokes equations. Just to prove that there exists a smooth solution, you get $1 million. So you cannot possibly theoretically solve Navier-Stokes equations for complex problems. Even for very simple problems, it is very difficult to solve analytically. Of course, computationally people solve it. So almost all the problems that you can solve are very simple in nature, just like this problem. This is a two-dimensional problem, first of all, and there are several assumptions here. First assumption is not the first assumption, there are several assumptions involved, but one of the assumptions is that the flow is only in the one direction. You can see here, only in x direction. So we assume that there is no vertical velocity. So right away you have v equal to 0. Okay, this is from intuition. If you have a parallel plate parallel to the bottom wall, class is going. So parallel to the bottom wall and the plate is being pulled parallelly, then all the flow also should happen parallel to both the plates. That is in the x direction. There is no y direction velocity. So v is 0. Now if you use this in the continuity equation, what you get from continuity equation? Dou u by dou x is 0. Because v is 0, so derivative of v is also 0 with respect to y. Therefore u is only a function of y. It is not a function of x, because partial derivative with respect to x is 0. So this is the information that we get from continuity. Now let us simplify the x momentum and y momentum equations. I hope you are following this. If there is any question, please stop me and ask the question. Just write in the chat window. Okay, so x momentum equation. Also here, our assumption is that this is a steady state problem to make it simpler. Otherwise, we will not be able to solve it analytically. So we'll say all the time derivatives are zero. There is no change with time. It is steady state. Let us also keep writing the assumptions here. Parallel flow, or you can say unidirectional flow. The second assumption, steady flow. So dou u by dou t goes to zero. What about the second term? U dou u by dou x. Is it zero or non-zero? Can you write in the chat window? This term, circle term, others also please write. Okay, now let us see. From continuity equation, if you see this term here, we said that dou u by dou x is zero, right? So this is the multiplication of u and dou u by dou x. So this is also zero. That's clear, I think. What about the third term? V dou u by dou y. Is it zero or non-zero? The third term. Yeah, again, pay close attention to the two terms there. It is a multiplication of V and dou u by dou y. Okay. Yes. So this term is also zero because V is zero. We wrote this here. V is zero. Okay. Now let us go to the right hand side. So here we saw that all the terms on the left hand side became zero because of our assumptions, which are valid assumptions. Okay, under certain conditions. We want a steady state velocity profile here. We want steady state solution. This plate has not been started from the beginning. It was not like it was at rest and then we suddenly started it. It has been moving for some time and we want the velocity and pressure there. Okay. Now on the right hand side, dou p by dou x. Do we know anything about that? Pressure gradient. So let us not talk about that right now. Let us go to the other terms. Okay, what about dou 2u by dou x square? Can you please write whether it is zero or non-zero? Second derivative of velocity with respect to x. Yes, correct answers. This is zero because dou u by dou x is zero everywhere. So the derivative of dou u by dou x is also zero everywhere. What about dou 2u by dou y square? Is it zero or non-zero? Okay, correct. This is non-zero. Because u is a function of y, we don't know what kind of function of y. So we have to assume that it is non-zero. All right. So the x momentum equation becomes and now we are writing total derivatives d2u by dy square because u is only a function of y. It is not a function of x. So we removed the partial derivative sign. This is the x momentum equation. Now let us go to y momentum equation. Again, the first term we have assumed steady state. This is anyway zero. What about the second term? Just write about the second term, zero or non-zero. Okay. Some of you are correct, some of you are wrong. So we have already said here that vertical velocity is zero, v is zero. So derivative of v with respect to x will also be zero. So because dou v by dou x is zero, therefore this entire term goes to zero. Similarly, this term also will be zero because v is present there. This is dou 2 v by dou y square. Even these two terms will be zero because v is zero. Okay, I hope that is fine. Now, because of this, you can see here दैट डो पी बाई डो वाई इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दैट मीन्स प्रेशर इज कॉन्स्टेंट इन द वाई डायरेक्शन और प्रेशर कैन ओनली बी अ फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स. नाउ यू कैन नोटिस वन मोर थिंग हियर. इफ वी हैड अ ग्रेविटी टर्म इन द वाई डायरेक्शन, राइट नाउ वी अज्यूम दैट देर इज नो ग्रेविटी. इफ वी हैड सम ग्रेविटी टर्म, इट विल बी रिटन एज माइनस रो जी. देन यू विल सी दैट डो पी बाई डो वाई विल बी इक्वल टू माइनस रो जी. सो प्रेशर विल बी लीनियर फंक्शन ऑफ वाई. ओके, इट विल बी रो जी वाई, विच इज द हाइड्रोस्टैटिक कंडीशन. बिकॉज देर इज नो फ्लो इन द वाई डायरेक्शन, सो द प्रेशर विल जस्ट लीनियरली इंक्रीज इन द वाई डायरेक्शन. बट राइट नाउ वी हैव अज्यूम नो ग्रेविटी, देयरफॉर प्रेशर कैन ओनली बी अ फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स. ओके, नाउ यू हैव टू इक्वेशंस हियर. प्रेशर इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स एंड वन मोर इक्वेशन हियर, डो पी बाई डो एक्स, विच कैन बी रिटन एज डी पी बाई डी एक्स. नाउ सो नाउ फ्रॉम दीज टू यू गेट डी पी बाई डी एक्स इक्वल टू म्यू डी टू यू बाई डी वाई स्क्वायर. Now we have used all the equations. We have no more equations here. And we have two unknowns, pressure and velocity. How do we solve this equation? Now again, going back to the experiments or our intuition from the experiments. We know that for such a flow where the flow is driven only by the motion of the top plate, there is no pressure difference between a point here and a point here. Only if there is a pump or something pushing the fluid, there will be a pressure difference. If the flow is driven only due to top plate, then there will be no pressure difference in the two points here. Okay, so using that information, we can say that this is equal to zero. So here you see that there are a lot of assumptions and there are a lot of information that we need from the experiments. Okay, and one more thing. Even if this was driven by a pump, let's say, so that pressure was not uniform everywhere, one thing that you can derive from this equation is that the left-hand side is only a function of x because pressure is only a function of x, right? So this is only a function of x, g prime x. And velocity is only a function of y. So this is some function of y. How can a function of x be equal to a function of y? Only when both of these are constants. So both of them cannot contain any x or y. They have to be equal to a constant. Now this is a special case where that constant is zero for this problem. But if this flow was driven by a pump or something which generates a pressure gradient, even then dp by dx will have to be a constant. So pressure can only linearly vary in the x direction. So this is something important that you get from these equations, that pressure can only linearly vary in the x direction. Okay. Even if there was a pump or something that generates a pressure difference. Now let us solve this. Mu d2u by dy square equal to 0. We can also solve mu d2u by dy square equal to a constant. And then if we have the information about the pump or how much pressure difference it generates, then the final equation will have this constant or dp by dx in it. Okay. So let us solve mu d2u by dy square equal to 0. Du by dy is a constant. C1, let's call it. Finally, velocity is a linear function in y. Now you can also imagine if this was not zero, if this was some c, then velocity will be a quadratic function in y. That problem we'll discuss later on. For now, this is equal to zero. Now, what are these constants C1 and C2? How do you find them out? We need some extra conditions which are known as boundary conditions. We know the boundary conditions. We know that at the top plate, velocity is equal to capital U. At the bottom plate, velocity is zero. And this is our coordinate system. This is y equal to zero. And this is y equal to some h, the height h. So let us use the first boundary condition. At y equal to zero, u is zero. So u is 0 at y equal to 0. So c2 is 0. From the second boundary condition, what do you get? U is capital U, which is equal to c1h plus c2, which is 0. C1 is u by h. Finally, velocity is u y by h. So you can see if you put y equal to 0, from here you get u equal to 0. If you put y equal to capital H, you get u equal to capital U. And what does this look like? At any cross section, it looks like this. This is capital U at the top, and linearly it goes down to zero. So this is a linear velocity profile that we talked about earlier. And we also said that stress tau xy or tau yx, both are same. This is equal to mu du by dy for this case, which was the Newton's law of viscosity. Here, what is du by dy? It is capital U by capital H. So mu u by h. And what is tau xy here? If you know the force on this plate or the tension in this wire or this string, which will be mg, if you have a block of mass m pulling this plate, so mg will be equal to the tension. And what will be stress tau xy? This will be this tension divided by the area of this plate, which is contacting this fluid. So force per unit area, that is the tangential stress. Therefore, mg divided by area of the plate is equal to mu u by h. H is the height of the plate from the bottom or the from the table. So you can easily find the viscosity of a fluid using this experiment. Viscosity will be equal to mg capital H divided by AU. So using this experiment, we can find out viscosity of any liquid or any fluid. Now you can see if for the same mass of the block, same gravity, if velocity is higher, if velocity is more, that means viscosity of the fluid is less. That is intuitive also. You can imagine if it floats, if it moves slowly, that means that the fluid is more viscous. Also, there are a lot of assumptions here. We have assumed an infinite plate. We are not talking about the end effects here. Okay. So there may be some error in this formula when you are doing the experiments. So generally, we don't have an infinitely large plate or such a big experimental setup. So generally, they use a cone. So this is a cone and plate rheometer, a rheometer that we have in CIF at ICER Bhopal. This is known as a rheometer, which measures viscosity. So rheology is study of viscosity or how viscosity is related to stresses for different fluids. And rheometer just means a meter which measures viscosity or related properties of the fluid. So it is a cone basically, and there is a plate. And this cone rotates like this. So instead of having a long plate, there is fluid sandwiched between this cone and this plate, and it rotates. The torque is measured. And from that torque, the shear stress is measured acting on this cone. And that is related to the viscosity and the velocity of the cone. Is there any question till this point? I hope all of this is very clear. Okay. If there are no questions, we'll stop here. In the next class, we'll have a quiz, next live class. Thank you.